Namaskar, Om Namah Shivaya, Hari Om, and thank you, Amarjitji, for this invitation to speak at this International Day of Yoga Symposium organized by All Party Parliamentary Group on Indian Traditional Sciences and High Commission of India. I'm deeply touched to hear that such an All Party Parliamentary Group on Indian traditional sciences exists in the UK and has existed since 2014. And I'm also very happy to hear that there are efforts to establish similar groups in other countries like the Czech Republic. Germany is in deep need for something like this. So it's so wonderful to hear about the efforts there. It's wonderful to listen to all the speakers here, members of parliament and high commissioner of Sri Lanka and highly esteemed speakers and teachers. So it's a wonderful symposium. And it's also wonderful to hear you, Amarjitji, speak and see the efforts of APPG, all this enthusiasm about the need to get yoga, Ayurveda and other traditionals Indian sciences recognized by the government and to establish training and practicing standards and to involve parliamentarians in these efforts. It's wonderful to hear MPs speak on this. I'm sure in Germany there will also be parliamentarians who speak about what they had for experience with Ayurveda and yoga, but so far they keep their experience a little more hidden, only speak in a personal level, but not publicly. So it's wonderful that UK is here very leader in this movement. I want to just bring a few more points of view from Germany. In India, traditional sciences have been transferred from guru to disciple. The disciple used to live for the teacher and learned, or he learned from his father. Today, yoga is taught in classes. Yoga teachers are trained in yoga teachers training courses by many private studios. In Germany, we have several yoga teachers, associations, and federations who try to establish high standards. Every yoga teachers association has their own standard. There's some common ground and some differences. And unfortunately, so far it has not been able, it wasn't possible to get them together. And so you have some yoga schools who have very little standard, others have higher standards. On those who seek recognition by one of the teachers' associations, typically they have higher standards. Now in Germany, yoga is recognized as a discipline of prevention by German social security system. Yoga courses can be reimbursed by public health insurance. That's a very good thing in Germany, which makes that many who would not be capable of paying for yoga courses come to take yoga. And also it gives some recognition for it. And the public health insurance system sets standards for yoga teachers' training courses. There are advantages and disadvantages for this to have a governmental institution set standards. An advantage is the standards are high in terms of number of lessons and scientific guidance and standards. A disadvantage in the German model was that these standards have been established without consultation of any yoga teachers association. In fact, the scientific advisors have especially been asked not to talk to any of the yoga associations, which was a little bit strange. And so something came out, which in the end is a good way, a good standard. But it could have been better if they had talked to the yoga teachers associations. So I'm very happy to see that in United Kingdom, there's a parliamentary group working together with Ayurvedic doctors and yoga teachers. And I would strongly recommend that also yoga teachers associations will be included in any effort to get recognized. I'm sure there are yoga teachers associations in UK as well, and to get those their competence and their level of expertise in year-long setting of standards would be very important. I'm also a board member of several international yoga federations like Yoga European Yoga Federation, European Yoga Confederation, World Yoga Council, United Consciousness, European Federation of Yoga Teachers Associations, and each of them and many others want to set standards for training and teaching yoga. And by establishing good standards, it will be important to have as many on board as possible. Quite important, I think, would be to get everybody together. Yoga has an optimistic view of human being. Inside of human being is the divine, the good, the love, the compassion. Human being is happy helping others, feeling connected. Human being doesn't need to be a lot to be happy. One can find happiness within. One can find happiness in feeling one with nature. We feel happy if we feel connected with others. What is preventing humans to live in the spirit is tension and blockages. Yoga can help remove these inner blockages, remove tension. Thus, the inner intelligence can awaken. A feeling of joy and love awakens. A deep urge to engage in helping others becomes stronger. And I'm sure a world can become more peaceful, more harmonious, more loving when more and more practice yoga. Today is International Day of Yoga in the whole world. Many international symposiums, festivals, workshops are taking place, mostly online. But millions of yoga practitioners practice together today, feeling connected. May the vibration of this International Day of Yoga spread waves of peace, harmony, and love. Let us all commit ourselves to spreading yoga from a spirit of unity for a spirit of unity. And many thanks to this all-party parliamentary group, which is such a good name, all-party parliamentary group, and thanks especially to Amarjitji for his efforts to bring everybody together. Thank you very much.